Welcome to Create of IMedia. The aim of this short presentation is to help you as a parent support your child with their upcoming PPEs. My name is Miss Futor and I am the subject lead for computer science and Creative IMedia here at Trinity. At present, there are no official changes that have been made to the course. However, the exam board, OCR, have put a proposal forward to Ofqual to suggest that the number of units required is reduced from four to three, and that any units that have been completed and submitted before June 2020 for them to be an assessed grade. For our students, this would mean that R081, which is the exam unit, would be an assessed grade. As soon as I get more information, I will pass this on to both students and parents. On the week beginning November the 9th, Creative IMedia students will sit their pre-public exams. Students will complete one past paper, which will be a 60-mark question paper that will last 1 hour 15 minutes. Students should try to spend around 1 minute per mark to ensure that they complete the full paper within the allocated time period. The exam paper is split into four learning objectives. Learning objective 1 and 3 of the exam paper will concentrate on the different pre-production documents that students have had experience of learning and making both last year and this year. Students must ensure they revise all of the different pre-production documents, knowing the purpose of the pre-production document, why it would be used, and what the pre-production document would contain. For learning objective 2 of the exam paper, students need to be able to interpret a client brief and answer questions based upon the client brief and their requirements. They will also need to understand the different categories of target audience and how different target audience would impact on how a product would be created. Examples of primary and secondary research will also be required and used to help fit the client requirements. There is a huge emphasis on this section for students to be reading the client requirements and ensuring that they meet the client's needs. They may be asked to create a work plan or production schedule that incorporates tasks, activities, and the timescales for the client, as well as ensuring that they have chosen the appropriate hardware and software for that media product. Students will also need to include health and safety considerations as well as legislation when looking at the client requirements, ensuring that they have thought about location recce, risk assessments, and the different legislation and laws that are in place when creating a media product. The final section of the exam paper, Learning Objective 4, concentrates on the reviewing of the pre-production documents. In order for students to achieve high marks on this question, they need to ensure that they are referencing back to the question, making it appropriate to the scenario and the target audience. They need to give a balanced view of both the strengths and weaknesses of the pre-production document, whilst also suggesting improvements and giving information as to why they have suggested those improvements. Students also need to ensure that they are using subject-specific terminology within their answer and that there are few, if any, spelling and punctuation errors. In order for students to be successful with the reviewing of the pre-production documents, it is imperative that they know what the purpose and the use of the pre-production documents are, as well as what they should include in the different pre-production documents. I have gave each student a laminated A3 knowledge organiser that will help give them all of the information that they need for the content of this exam. In March 2020, all students were given a Creative IMedia revision guide to take home and use while school was closed. This revision guide is a fantastic resource to help students and help consolidate their learning with exam-style questions and checkpoints included throughout. There are so many different ways to revise, and it needs to be something that will work for you personally. My first suggestion is to create a revision timetable. This will enable you to know what needs to be done each night and help you focus and get into a routine of revising. You may find that for different subjects, different revision techniques work, and it is about experimenting what works best for you. Some of the effective ways in which students have revised for Creative IMedia in the past have been to create flashcards. They create flashcards of the content that they need to remember, including the keywords and definitions, and then get their parents to test them. For others, it has been to read and reread the revision guide, create mind maps, and also voice notes. Other students have found placing post-it notes in different places around the house of the information that they are struggling with also effective. There are also a lot of good videos on YouTube to help students with how to answer exam-style questions for those who are more of a visual learner. I have found that students who go over past exam papers have found it a really effective way of achieving their target grade, and I am more than happy to provide and mark exam papers if that is what students wish to do in order for them to be able to revise. Students can look at the Creative IMedia specification, which is on the OCR website, for them to understand what is required from them, as well as looking at their knowledge checkers to see not only what is needed, but also how confident they are on each section. There is also a great playlist on YouTube by RA Solutions for the R081 exam, which gives them a breakdown of what is needed for each learning objective. This is something that students may prefer, as this is more visual and has audio. The only way you will get to know what you need to revise is by testing yourself. There is no point revising something that you already understand. You need to go back through your knowledge checkers and past assessments and see the areas of improvement. This should be the first thing that you do when you start to revise. I have a number of past papers available to ensure that you have the best possible chance of achieving and even exceeding your target grade. Once completed, I will mark them and then give you feedback on how to improve them further. As previously mentioned, YouTube has some fantastic videos online for Creative IMedia, but we also have past exam questions on GCSE Pod that can be used to help aid revision as well. Starting today will help with tomorrow and every day after. Remember to make those strong choices so that when you get your results in August of 2021, you are proud of what you have achieved and you know that you have gave it your all.